Always your regards to the next frog you meet. What?
I think it froze.
It froze? Didn't that happen
last
time?
Oh, there it goes.
Yeah, that happened last time. It's not actually as crazy as you might think. Some species of frogs, such as sand frogs, do exist in desert regions like Africa. You can see this with little to no... some word I don't know. Swedes burrow in the ground to protect themselves from the harsh, dry climate.
Precipitation, it means rain.
Oh. We could just said rain. You need to equip the thing.
Yep.
Don't forget.
Oh.
Yeah, it'll make things... like these small increases, you'd think like 5 wouldn't make a big difference, but... it seems in the Earthbound games, it does... it does kind of show what, like, these small increases can make a difference. Frog should get his own game.
He did, it's called Frogger.
Poor guy.
Oh no! I dodged the Pachuk Ray!
Just throws a goddamn bomb at the thing.
That seems like a waste of a bomb. He didn't use our bomb, did he?
No.
Okay.
I don't think so. At least check in the inventory. I don't think so, because he should not have the wrong inventory.
Yeah, I still have my running bomb. Okay.
Yeah, it was his own.
Oh, well, that's not too bad.
So, let me check the walkthrough. Yeah, well, essentially what you need to go is, you just need to go through the desert. Until you bump into a cutscene.
Oh, some more nut bread.
It heals wounds.
More nutting and bread.
Ew.
Hey, at least you can say it's not nuttin' or nothing.
I did not ask for this. So, you got anything you want to talk about? Because this part of the game's a bit boring, to be honest. Well, it's not boring, it's more like, there's not that much to talk about, it's pretty straightforward.
Yeah, let's see. Well, first let me sell this dung, or give him the dung.
Give him poop, it'll give you experience.
Yeah, we're really good at giving this guy shit.
Yeah, you're very experienced in giving this guy. Leaving cardboard boxes of poop in front of his front door and setting it on fire.
Oh, that's more like legendary dung.
Wow. I've never had that happen, that I got 2 of them. Mainly because I probably didn't bother with it that much, but... that's really lucky. I've never had that happen before. I'm glad I could experience that. I'm glad I could experience 2 legendary shits.
This game's full of crap. I haven't played an RPG that made such a big deal about poop since I played Blue Dragon, which actually has an enemy called the Poop Snake that attacks you.
Dare I ask?
Look it up. Just look up poops. I think Blue Dragon and Poop Snake, and see what if you can get a picture of it.
It's called the Poo Snake, apparently. Oh. Well then. Well then. That's something. Who comes up with this stuff?
Akira Toriyama, creator of Dragon Ball Z.
Oh my. You know, honestly, I'm not too surprised it was him.
Especially if you see his earlier, before Dragon Ball Z work. Like, just Dragon Ball or Dr. Slump.
Yeah, I've seen some of that. I remember quite enjoying those.
Yep. I actually like those better than Dragon Ball Z, though I still do enjoy Dragon Ball Z.
I mean, when I was a kid, Dragon Ball Z was the shit, because it was people screaming for hours at end. But looking back, I think Dragon Ball and Dr. Slump were definitely superior shows.
I think the thing with Blue Dragon is I think it didn't sell as much as they were hoping it would, considering the people behind it. Blue Dragon had Akira Toriyama, and it also had the guy who used to do all the soundtracks for Final Fantasy, and yet I think it only sold decently, for lack of better words.
This game actually had a similar problem because it was a lot of hype, and apparently people in Japan thought this was disappointing. People in Japan are fucking stupid!
Yeah, they even made a Blue Dragon anime to kind of coincide with the game, but eh.
Nah, don't you worry, literally. Literary Raven, when I fucked that name up. Don't pardon your language, because, you know, we are talking about shit and dicks. Because we are potty-mouthed pissheads.
That lizard still looks like somebody stepped on him.
It was probably facade.
He's a big fatty. Did you see the Super Mario Brother anime whenever I played that?
The anime?
Yeah.
Wasn't that like a movie?
Yeah.
No, I don't think I have.
The people who made that movie did not know the difference between a Mexican and an Italian.
So Mario's Mexican?
Well, there's two random scenes in it where Mario just randomly dons a poncho and a sombrero for no explained reason.
Okay.
One is just this picture they show in the opening. The other one is he gets pissed off and he actually randomly gets his sombrero poncho and starts shooting guns in the air.
Well, you know, in the Super Mario Bros. Cartoon, the Western one, you do know that when he's of course a Italian stereotype, and he eats pasta with no toppings.
He just eats.
Yeah, right. He eats just, you know, cooked noodles with nothing on them.
But he just eats, period, on that cartoon. But yeah, it's funny. It's like the Japanese anime movie didn't know the difference between Mexicans and Italian. The Super Mario Super Show, it's like it's over pushing the Italian stereotype. It's like they can't go 5 seconds without mentioning, like, nervous noodles.
Well, I do know that, well, we laugh at stereotypes. We don't think they're good.
No. Well, they toned that down a lot in,
It's the Tongue Mother alone! Take all that back and get all the experience. Maybe we'll get more legendary shit.
Maybe. They toned down the Italian stereotype thing, though, in the following Mario cartoons. Granted, there's still a scene in Super Mario 3 cartoon where Mario actually says, "King Koopa's giving up? That's impossible!"
But, dude, take back the dung. I want to know if we got a third legendary shit. That'd be great.
The shit of legends.
Yeah. But, you know, either way, you'll get experience. You get out of 5, 10, or 50 experience. And it's random.
I kind of wish they took it a little further to where the dung beetle, like, tells you how great the texture or smell of it is.
I don't know. But, at any rate, I think, yeah, after you take back the dung and get more experience, I think we're good to go.
Alright.
And we can move on. Because, you may remember that Facade was in Tasmania Village, and we did see Sarsa there.
Let's see.
If you remember from last stream, do you?
No.
Well, it's been a while, and of course, you're going blind into this game, and I know it really, really, really well.